Yes, at the outset, I seek your indulgence about the timing. Such a voluminous bill, even if I mention the points, it will take more than 5 minutes. Number two, I will not elaborate my points, to be sure, to take care of the time limit. And I will just mention, it is a bullet point. At the outset, my first suggestion is that if at all, I don't find anywhere in the statement and objects and reasons the point of supporting the small and medium scale industries who are need to be supported. I don't find in the statement of an object and reason. If that be so, I am not taking that for granted, as Mr. Chidambaram has assumed in his deliberation, that this clause may be meant for helping the SMEs. I am not assuming, but even if we did, I fully agree with Mr. Chidambaram that there must be some separate set. There's some relaxation, some allowance for the SMEs, but at the same time, if the same relaxations and allowance is resorted to by the large companies, practically then the whole project of ease of doing business will be converted into ease of taking the country to ransom, as that has been happening among the major private corporates, creating 11 lakh crore rupees of NPA, taking the bank money but not paying it, yet enjoying a very honorable stance in the society. And also their income tax due, after all concessions, remains more than 4 to 5 lakh crore a year. Despite all these things, if they are again allowed this set of liberalization, 2013 a comprehensive bill was passed. Again, many provisions need to be liberalized for all. I don't think finally it is not going to do the real ease of doing business for employment generation, but finally lead to ease of taking the country to ransom, as is seen at present. Practically, SMEs are facing a decline in our country. All kind of petty production and petty manufacturing, petty service generations are facing a decline. And many of whom are being seen as SMEs, a big part of them are proxy companies of the big, large corporates. That is a reality. So in that background, this bill creates a lot of apprehension. And now I quickly make the bullet points only. Number one, private major companies, do they do business out of their own money? They take money from bank, out of public deposits, are supplying capital to them. Now, in such kind of a situation, the prohibition of insider trading, whatever they are in 2013 Act, when that prohibition is lifted, it means you are promoting to speculation, putting the capital for employment generating and wealth generating activities, you are making way for draining out the resources. And again, the resources are not their own, taken loan from the bank to become subsequent defaulter for saying this reason or that reason. You are paving the way, opening the door for speculation, and that is not going generate employment, as you have mentioned in your employment statement or objection reasons, that will only promote provision. There is absolutely no rationale, and I demand upon the minister, please drop that amendment. The prohibition, restriction must continue inside the trading regime, and I agree that from the SEBI provisions, the regulatory provision, it must be consistent and compliant to that, not merely harmonization. So this must be, my second point is that the remove restriction, allow for exempting class of foreign companies from registering and compliance regime under the Act. The foreign companies will be operating here. There is a myth. Not necessarily. They will bring the entire money. They will bring some. and then they will raise money from our level, our. There is a stock market, there is a share market. Now you are exempting them from the compliance regime altogether. What is the rationale behind that? How the national interest will be served by that? Accepting, pleasing or appeasing the government of their home countries, the foreign companies are coming from where? I think this clause also should be dropped altogether. Then the question of putting many things under the discretionary authority of the executive by shifting it to rules, that undermines the authority of the parliament, and that must be not be there. It must be put in it. Because once the provision is in the body of the bill, that becomes much more enforceable and justiciable than when you are putting it in the rule. You are creating a ground for executives to rent seeking out of application of rule or exercise of the rule, and which has become an order of the day. The rent seeking, please, I'm completing within a minute. So this clause also must go. The things should be brought in the body of the bill, not in the rules. Then again, last point, you made a lot of music about the 2013 Act, that you have done a very big thing, brought the private companies under the corporate social responsibilities. When from parliamentary committee, I have an occasion to interact with the company affairs ministry's official, when we told that from 15-16, you have to monitor how the private companies are spending money on CSR as per the obligation under the law. They told that we have nothing more to do except to receive a statement for them that why they have not spent the money on CSR. And matter ends there. There is no force enforceability of that clause that private companies are also to spend 2% of their net profit on company corporate social responsibility. Although a lot of noise was made that such a revolutionary clause was incorporated in the Companies Act, and now you are further diluting it. You are making a provision so that the net profit can be shown less. What are the items not to be included in the net profit? So that their obligation under corporate social responsibility further goes down.
Samapt kijiye.
Just conclude.
No, sir. Please
conclude. In two clauses, 35 and 36, you are completely making the provision of CSR by the private companies a farce, a mockery. Practically withdrawing of that provision altogether. This is nothing but a mockery. So this also should be altogether changed.
Dhanyavaad.
And last, And the last point, how you are going to, you are giving leverage for ensuring ease of doing business. But how, there is another point in the your statement on objection and reason. The established accountability, how you are going to do that? How are going to do that number of fake companies surfacing, take money from the market and then vanishes? Small investors are taken to ransom. How you are going to exercise and establish a proper accountability regime? These amendment initiative does not find any mention of that.
Dhanyavaad.
And so it remains that in the name of ease of doing business, you are paving the way to ease of taking the country to ransom. This exercise must stop, and this is my demand. Thank you.
Sri Naresh.